Sailor Jupiter Lita here, and today I'm gonna talk about this one thing that, well, I don't know if, I don't think it's bad or anything. No, it's not bad or anything, but at the same time it's something that I have to talk about. So, alright, where do I go with this? Alright. So, I get this a lot. We get this a lot from, you know. Anyway, here it goes. Alright. I'm not sure where I'm going with this. You know, I come on and I'm not sure where I'm going, but hell, just go with it. Okay. I mean, alright. So, everyone would like to ask us back in the day, oh, and this was mostly, this came from the haters, but not from anyone else, why you never edit. But that's a Latin bar where the English would be, why you never shift. Alright, you wanna know? One, it was too hard. The tools that we worked with were not that good when it came to doing that kind of thing. Yes, we did have Microsoft Windows back in the day, and we got Microsoft Windows again, but the Microsoft Windows film shifting tool wasn't actually that good when it came to cutting things out. And most of it, and all the time, it would besmirch your films. You know? Yes, if you want to make your film brighter, or you want to make your film darker, or you want to put a name on it, or some kind of outstanding drawing, or whatever you want to do, it could do that for you. But if you want to cut something out and put something in, that's when you were asking for too much. And then it took too long to fillet any of the shifts you made to your film. And it took too much time. And then there was also the ArcSoft ones. ArcSoft Webcam Friend and ArcSoft Webcam Fillayer. Same deal here. You know, they could, same deal here with the outstanding drawings and brightening and the darkening of the film and giving a name and all that other stuff. It was faster when it came to forlaying films once you were done making all your shifts to it. But if you want to cut something out, it couldn't do that at all. And if it did, it probably would besmirch your film too. And that's what led us to the last one we ever worked with, the CyberLink one. Our CyberLink one was broke, and the only thing it could actually do was film. It couldn't do nothing else, you know. Everything else was like shifted off, and you couldn't shift it on. So, you tell me if, you tell me if those, if that sound, if those, if anyone is, and some folks, if they're lucky enough and they got all the time, then maybe they'd skill one of those tools. Well, never gonna have the time and never gonna skill it. I skilled it, okay? You learned it, but guess what? Don't have to do that. Don't have all the time in the world to be fucking around with all of those film shifting tools, and half of them aren't as good as everyone makes them out to be. And we also think our films are the good the way they are, at least to us. At least to Dwayne, he thinks that. Now others are going to have their own thought and belief, and that is what it is. You know? In true life, you can't shift anything out of your film, so you can't shift anything out of true life when it happens, so why should you do it in your films? You know, we like the films the way they are, and that's lifelike. When that thing happens, that's life like, The only ones I believe that like to work with film shifting tools are flawless folk, folk who want everything to be flawless, and there's no such thing as flawlessness in this world. But those folks who want everything to be flawless are folks that are seeking to sell their stuff, like a film business or a farseer show business, and they want their stuff to look at least good. Those are the only two folks that would actually do those kind of films. Those are the only two folks that would work with that kind of tool. My mistake. I don't know why I said that for. But the truth is, you don't have to do any of that. There is no law or oversight that says, well, you gotta do this and you gotta do that with your film. You don't have to do that. Yeah, I'm sure a film business or a farseer show business could pick not to do any of that. Their work might not get sold that well, and it might not get over that well with whatever folk work or whoever film hall is going to run their film or farseer show true, but they don't have to do it. I'm not going to go play around with the tools I have and then fuck up the film. And oh, it doesn't really care, because then folks are going to say YouTube has one. Yeah, and the YouTube one is as bad as all the other ones I worked with too. And I know Microsoft has a new one too, but it's probably as broken and doesn't do what it's supposed to do. I bet you all it does is make your films brighter, make it darker. Might let you put in music and put some song in. It might let you, make some outstanding drawings, whatever, give it a name. But I bet you you're asking too much when you want to cut something out, because that's when it's going to break. That's when it's going to besmirch your film. And no, I'm sure the Apple's Macintosh iMovie is probably bad too. Same thing there, same deal. Mackie Cam, Sony Vegas, same deal. So I picked not to shift my films, because all the ones I worked with didn't really do a whole lot. And I know that the haters out there, they always talk about, you need to clean this out, you need to do that. Oh, and shifting is your friend. Well, shifting was my friend. Then it was a friend that could only help me with some of my work and not all of it. And if it was a friend, then it would ask me if it wanted to help, and I would say, no, I don't need any help. And the friend would say, that's good, I'm here if you need me. But then again, it would be a friend that could only help you with some of your work and not all of it if it was a friend, which it's not to me. All right, that's it. I'm Sailor Jupiter Lita. Hope you like this film.